So in this class, I will be looking at risk and uncertainty. Risk and uncertainty. What do we mean by risk? Risk is a situation whereby the possibility of future outcome of an event can be predicted from the past events due to the presence of the probability. I repeat, risk is a situation whereby the possibility of future outcome of an event can be predicted from the past events due to the presence of probability. On the other hand, uncertainty is a situation whereby the possibility of future outcome of an event cannot be predicted from the past events due to the absence of probability. If you look at the definition, the major difference between risk and uncertainty is that in terms of risk, probability of the estimate will be given. But in the case of an uncertainty, there will be no probability. So methods of measuring risk and uncertainty. Methods of measuring risk and uncertainty. Methods of measuring risk and uncertainty. Number one, we have the expected value method. Expected value method. Expected value method. Expected value method. Expected value is the product of the cash flow and its associated probability. The product of the cash flow and its associated probability. Expected value equal to the sum of probability times the cash flows. If the cash flow is denoted by letter X, the sum of the product of the cash flows and its associated probability is said to be the expected value. The second method is decision tree. Decision tree. The third method is standard deviation. Standard deviation method. Standard deviation. The fourth method is certainty. Certainty equivalent. Certainty equivalent value method. The fifth method is sensitivity. Sensitivity analysis or what if analysis method. What if? Number six, we have simulation. Simulation. Seven, we have risk adjusted cost of capital. Cost of capital. Risk adjusted cost of capital. Number eight, we have triple assessment. Triple assessment method. Triple assessment method. These are the methods. These are the methods of measuring risk and uncertainty. We have other methods, but we are going to limit our scope to this. So, okay, well, let me add this. Number nine, we have payoff matrix, or payoff table. So, these are the methods we are going to consider in this class. So, we want to start with expected value method. expected value method. We'll be taking them in order. What do we mean by expected value? I'm told you earlier that an expected value is the product or the sum of the product of the cash flows and its associated probability. The sum of the product of the cash flows and its associated probability is said to be the expected value. The sum of the product of the cash flows and its associated probability is the expected value. So let's take an example. Expected value, expected value. Example, Agao Limited. Agao Limited has to choose between two projects. A and B. The probabilities outcome and the cash flows and the cash flows associated with the projects are as follows. We have project A and project B. Then we have cost in dollar. So we have the probability. We also have probability of this, of project B. We have 0.3. The cash flow is 25,000. Then this one, 0.4, with the cash flow of 24,000. Then we have 0.6 with the cash flows of 20,000. We have 0.3 with the cash flows of 40,000. Then we also have 0.10 with the cash flows of 40,000. Then we also have 0.30 with the cash flows of 20,000. Both projects produce an income. Produce an income of 50,000 naira. Which of the projects should we choose? Which of the projects should be chosen? That is the question. Which of the projects should be chosen? So when recommending a project on the basis of the expected value, where revenue is involved, you choose the project with the highest expected revenue. And in case of this, you have cost. You want to minimize cost. So that means ordinarily you will choose the project with the lowest expected cost. So now let's consider project A. Solution. Project A. You have the probability of 0.0. 0.30 and 0.10. If you sum up the probability, it must be exactly equal to 1. The cost will be denoted by X and it's in dollar. We have 25,000, 20,000, and 40,000. 25,000, 20,000, and 40,000. So to calculate the expected value, you have the probability P times the cash flow X. That is why you have PX. So we have it at 0.3 times 25,000. And that will give us 7,500. 0.6 times 20,000. And that will give us 12,000. Then we have 0.1 times 40,000. And that will give us 4,000. So when you sum it up, so you have 4,000 plus 12,000 plus 7,500. Then you have the expected value to be 23,500. Expected value of the cost. Expected value of the cost for project A is $23,500. Then project B. Project B. You have the probability. You have the cash flow. The probability of project B. You have 0.4, then you have 0.3, then you have 0.3. If you sum it up, then you will call it that one. Then the cash flows for project B, you have 24,000, so 40,000 and 20,000. So the expected value, that is P times X. Yes. So it will be having 0.4 times 24,000. That will give us 9,600. Then 0.3 times 40,000. That will give us 12,000. And 0.3 times 20,000. That will equally give us 6,000. And when you sum it up, plus 12,000 plus 9,600, then you have 27,600. That is the expected value of the cost. So, on the basis of the expected value, project A has the least expected value of the running cost. Project A has the least of the expected value of the running cost. Therefore, project A should be chosen. Project A should be chosen. Project A should be chosen because it has the least expected value of the running. So we are going to consider that is all about expected value. So the next, so